Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, our today's topic is to study the phosphorus cycle. So coming to the phosphorus cycle, we need to know that phosphorus normally occurs in nature as part of a phosphate ion. So what are the sources of phosphate? It's found as salts in ocean sediments. It's present in rocks. So what is the importance of phosphate? It is an essential component of ATP, that's adenosine triphosphate. Phosphorus also plays a critical role in cell development and DNA formation, as you can see. It's an important component for the growth of plants. So what will happen if there is deficiency of phosphate? Delayed crop maturity would be there, reduced flower development. Low seed quality and decreased crop yield. High amount of accumulation of phosphate in lakes leads to eutrophication. We have already studied about eutrophication. The movement of phosphorus cycle is same as other cycles like nitrogen cycle and other cycles. So what happens? Phosphate, which is present in rocks, is transferred into soil by weathering of rocks. When rocks break down, plants can take up phosphate through roots. From plants, phosphate is transferred to animals when animals eat plants. From animals, it's transferred back to soil as excretory material when they die. From soil, it's transferred to oceans as phosphate sediments. Dissolved phosphates are transferred to oceans through soil erosion and more usage of fertilizers, because in fertilizers we use phosphate. In oceans, its amount is increased by aquatic plants and animal excretion and their death. Phosphate returns back to rocks by absorbing of phosphate sediments from the oceans. So this is all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.